G'day guys, thought we'd drop a tree for a bit more forward. Probably this sucker here. So yeah, we'll get stuck into it. Okay, so then with this carpenter's rule, I'm just going to check which way it's going to fall. It's probably, for me, it's probably more of a bit of an art and a bit of good luck rather than a science. Got no training whatsoever. So the way that triangle's pointing, I don't know if you can see that, it's pointing that way. That's exactly the way I want it to go. And it has got a forked limb, quite a heavy one, pointing that way. So with a bit of luck, we should be there. Bit more work to do on this notch. Happy with my notch, and I'm going to drop this with the crosscut saw. So now I need to take the bark off. What happens is the dirt, the grit, gets taken up as the tree grows, and it actually gets embedded inside the bark here. So it's actually a lot easier to sharpen an axe than it is to sharpen a saw. So we'll get cracking into that. So once again, we're just making sure that saw is perfectly aimed to where we want to drop it. Getting a bit tight. So as you can see, I did finally get the old two-man crosscut saw started. It's definitely the way to go. It's definitely much better quality. As I said, it's a tapered ground, which of course means that it's not going to bind up as much. But on the other bad point about it is it's a lot wider, so I've got to wait a bit to drive a wedge in. But we should be right. We're going to give her a few whims. Alright, there she is, down right where I wanted her. Had a few issues with the wind there, but went quite well. Alrighty.